So guys, we're going to talk about brake systems. The first thing I want to bring up is how important brake systems are, not only to stop us, but DOT actually monitors your brakes. They got together with the manufacturers. They made these standards. These standards cannot be changed, and they're also our check. So it's our responsibility to keep our brake systems up. The feds are very, very strict about this, that they catch you on the side of the road with any kind of brake defects, that's gonna be considered out of service. Okay guys, so the first thing we're gonna go over on the brake system is gonna be the heart of the system. It's gonna be the compressor, the dryer, the governor. The governor and dryer are usually together, or the compressor is, or the governor is actually mounted on the compressor, and also the storage tanks. So on this particular truck, the compressor is gonna be towards the back of the engine. It's kind of tough to see here. That's the compressor down here. It's a dual piston compressor. There's gonna be dual piston compressors, single piston compressors. What they're gonna do is just draw in the air, compress it, send it through the dryer. The dryer, of course, is gonna take out any kind of humidity into the that's in the air, and it's gonna go ahead and store it into your tanks. On this particular truck, the storage tanks are gonna be behind this fairing here. So as you can see here, these are gonna be your storage tanks. Each truck is gonna be different, but mostly you're gonna have a secondary and a primary, or a primary and a secondary. And of course, this is gonna be the actual tank coming, the supply tank. So all three of these tanks are gonna be filled with air. When your truck is running correctly, when the compressor is running like it's supposed to, you should at high RPM, you should be able to reach 100 PSIs and within 25 seconds. The other component that I mentioned is going to be the dryer. On this particular truck, the dryer is located. It's kind of tough to see. It's going to be behind this frame rail. You're not going to be able to see it. Dryers are located in a lot of different places on trucks, but basically what dryers do, as I mentioned, is dry out the air. You don't want a lot of moisture in your air system, you know, because what that's going to end up doing is causing leaks. It's causing valves to leak. It's just going to be a mess. Your tanks here are going to have drain knobs on them. It's very, very good practice to drain these at least once a week, depending on the hot and cold weather. Currently, we're having very cold weather in the morning and hot in the afternoon. So, of course, that's going to be condensation. Next thing we're going to be moving into is the actual controls. So let's move on to the controls, and I want to point out a few things that run this system. Okay guys, so as I mentioned, we're going to be moving to the control systems. The control systems are in place to control, of course, the air applied to each wheel. If of course your truck will build up to 120 PSI. If you were to hit the brakes and there was not a control system there, you can get 120 pounds to that wheel and it would lock right up. The first valve I want to point out to you is going to be the foot valve. The foot valve is part of the control system. It's split up in two different circuits, the primary and the secondary. One is for the front and the other one's for the rear. And that is a mandate there since the 70s. Both systems need to be on separate circuits. Bendix is one of the ones that came up with that style. The next valve I want to point out to you here is a ABS valve here on the axle. That's going to, of course, regulate air and also monitor your wheel speed. If it seems any kind of, if it receives a signal as if this wheel is actually stopped rolling, it's going to release the air. That's what part of the ABS system. Another piece of the ABS system is going to be at the rear of the truck. So let's move to the rear and I'll give you a chance to take a look at that. Okay guys, so we're back here to the back of the truck. I'm gonna point out there's a few main valves back here. We got a very important valve here in the center. Basically what it does is sends an amplifying signal from the foot valve. So as soon as you hit the brake, there's gonna be a signal ready to release air to these brake chambers. On both sides of those, you got the ABS valve, which does the same as the front ABS valve. Down here, we have a quick release valve. Basically, this valve just quickly releases the air once you're ready to set the brakes. So as you can see, there's a lot of different controls and valves to these systems. It's basically, they're here to create great brake balance and to make sure your system's working correctly. Okay guys, so the last thing I'd like to mention is all your hardware, all these components. Anytime you have a repair, you wanna change them with the same exact part. Okay, these are specified brake systems already designed by the manufacturer. You don't want to change any of that. Okay, so We also are going to link a video above on how to change brakes if you're interested in changing your own brakes. If you have any comments on something, I know that we probably didn't cover exactly everything on this brake system, but if you got any comments, comment below. If you got any questions, also comment below. Subscribe. We're going to be putting more content out there, guys. So until next time, be safe.